Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss the chemiosmotic theory. How would you write if you get such a question in the university exam? So in the Kuhar's question which has come is explain the chemiosmotic hypothesis. I had already discussed the chemiosmotic hypothesis when I dealt with biological oxidation and electron transport chain. But today I'm just going to specifically explain how to answer this question when it comes as such, just the chemiosmotic hypothesis. Now, as you all know, the passage of electrons from one complex to the other in the electron transport chain generates energy for the pumping out of protons into the intermembrane space. So 10 protons are pumped out by the complexes 1, 3 and 4. Now this pumping of protons, it creates an unequal distribution of hydrogen ions on the two sides of the inner mitochondrial membrane. What are the two sides? On one side you have the matrix and on the other side you have the intermembrane space. So there is unequal distribution of hydrogen ions on the two sides of the inner mitochondrial membrane, and this results in the development of a proton gradient across the inner mitochondrial membrane. This proton gradient is accompanied by a proton motive force. Now this proton motive force has got two components. One is the chemical potential energy. And this chemical potential energy is due to a difference in the concentration of hydrogen ions on the two sides of the inner mitochondrial membrane. And an electrical potential energy due to a difference in the charge on the two sides of the inner mitochondrial membrane. So the energy inherent or energy which is present in this proton gradient is used to synthesize ATP from ADP and inorganic phosphate, and this is catalyzed by the enzyme ATP synthase. Now what is this chemiosmotic theory? This was proposed by the British biochemist Peter Michell in 1961. So it basically explains the mechanism of oxidative phosphorylation, and there are three basic principles. One is the major electron carriers, that is the complexes 1, 3 and 4 are organized along the inner mitochondrial membrane. So these are the electron carriers which are organized as complexes on the inner mitochondrial membrane. Now secondly, the energy released during the transport of electrons from one carrier to another allows the protons to be pumped across the inner mitochondrial membrane into the intermembrane space. The inner mitochondrial membrane is impermeable to protons. So this pumping results in a larger or a higher concentration of protons in the intermembrane space. And this is the reason why you have the generation of an electrochemical potential, or otherwise known as the proton motive force. Now this proton motive force will make the hydrogen to flow back into the mitochondrial matrix down its electrochemical gradient through a specific hydrogen ion channel or proton pore which is present in the ATP synthase complex. So it only flows back along its electrochemical gradient through this specific ion channel or proton pore of the ATP synthase complex. Now the energy which is released as the hydrogen ion flows back into the zone of lower hydrogen ion concentration, this energy is coupled with the phosphorylation of ADP to ATP. So this in a sense is what you should write when you are asked about the chemiosmotic theory. Okay, so thank you.